What's up, guys? Welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we aim to teach you everything you need to know to make it as a streamer or a content creator in the gaming niche. Today's video, we're going to be looking at a brand new feature in Streamlabs OBS. Something that they've had in the back end of Streamlabs OBS for a little while, but they haven't linked it to alerts until this latest release, and that is face masks. Now, what face masks are they are ways that your viewers can donate and apply a special filter to your webcam that, you know, like those silly Snapchat filters where they make you into a dog and things like that. They can choose one of these filters and it will apply live to you in your stream within Streamlabs OBS. I'm going to teach you all about it, talk to you about all the different types of filters, and show you exactly how to set it up in this video. So let's check it out. So I think the main reason that Streamlabs OBS have decided to add this feature is obviously to encourage donations. This is a massive incentive for your viewers to be able to have more of an impact on your stream by donating. So previously, people have been able to, you know, write messages and maybe have text-to-speech converting their donation message, but this is a real way to interact and, you know, make other people that are watching your stream laugh. I think it's a really great idea, and I haven't seen many people using it, even though it came out in the latest version of Streamlabs OBS, and maybe that's because they don't know about it yet. Hopefully, I am going to be teaching everybody how to do it and encouraging more people to use it, but it's definitely going to incentivize your viewers to donate to you more because they're going to have more of an impact on the outcome of your stream. It is probably worth me mentioning that this is exclusive to Streamlabs OBS, so this functionality does not exist within regular OBS Studio. Obviously, Streamlabs OBS are trying to create some features that differentiate themselves from the core OBS Studio package that they brought over when they first came out with the software. But I think this really is one of the greater features and one of the reasons some people might start to transition over to Streamlabs OBS. So obviously, if you haven't yet downloaded Streamlabs OBS, I have a link at the top of the description where you can download it. And we're going to have a look at the 17 filters now that are included within the face mask feature. So as you can see, Streamlabs OBS have come out with 17 different face masks on this release. I'm sure they're going to add more over time, and I don't know if they're going to open up for developers to add more and things like that. I'd imagine so, but for now we have 17 to choose from, and you can see underneath each one that they have a rarity. So let's just have a look through some of the ones that you can get. They have one called teabag, which seems to drop a teabag on your head and sort of affect the shape of your face. Calculated, which is that one with all the mass equations running around your head. Hot dogs, golden god, make it rain. You can see some of the examples here, but they also, as you can see underneath, have a rarity for each one. So the reason that the masks have a rarity comes down to how the actual face mask donation works. If you as a viewer go to donate to one of your streamers that have face masks enabled, how it works is you will roll a random mask to unlock it permanently. So to start, you'll roll a random mask, and based on its rarity, you can see some of them will be more common to unlock than others. Your randomly rolled mask will then appear on the streamer's face. So the first time you donate, you really have no choice as to what mask is going to appear, but your randomly rolled one will appear along with your donation message. You can then, since you have unlocked this mask, use it in future donations, or you can choose to randomly roll to unlock a different one. So if you're donating often to a streamer, then you're going to have, you know, lots of choices as to which face mask gets used. But if you are just looking to donate once, then it's going to be completely random. And obviously, the more rare ones are more rare that they're going to be appearing above the streamer's face. Okay, so I've convinced you and you've decided that you want to enable these face alerts into your stream to encourage more donations from your viewers. How do you actually go about doing it? Well, it's very, very simple. You come across to your Streamlabs OBS software, go across to the dashboard, and you should see an option down here that says face masks. So if you click that, you'll see an example of some of the face masks being used, and all you have to do is click here to enable face masks, and you get the choice of which device you want to add the face masks to. So here obviously is where you're going to be selecting your webcam, your camera, if you have a capture card, or however you're capturing your camera, this is where you need to select it. So for me, I've got a mirrorless camera plugged into an Elgato Camlink, so I need to select that device here. If you have a webcam, this will be the name of your webcam. Really, it's whatever the source is called in Streamlabs OBS anyway. So just click save, and you can see that we have a few different options here to play with. I'm sure more options are going to come around, but for now, it's really just how long you want the face mask to last for and how loud you want the alert volume to play for. So I personally would turn the volume down a bit just because of how I've got my stream set up, and maybe I'd reduce the duration from 20 seconds, but we can leave that at default. Click save settings and then everything should be set up for you. Once you've done that, you can come back across to the editor or the actual the stream setup section of Streamlabs OBS, come down to the bottom right, click test widgets. You should see you've got this mask button now, and if you click that, you should see a test of what it would look like when somebody donates. So let's see which one I get. And there you go, I got the purple eyes, I think they're called, or sparkly eyes, and you can see where the donation message will come as well. So you can keep on clicking through mask, see some of the variations that come up. This looks so silly with me talking whilst having these eyes. And I really do think that this is going to be an amazing feature, one which honestly might make some people switch from regular OBS to Streamlabs OBS. I really can't wait to see what they do in the future in terms of more face masks. I'd love to see like a disco one where, you know, disco lights are going on and maybe you get like a big Afro 80s wig type thing. I think there's so many options here to really spice up your stream and make donating a real incentive for your viewers. Hopefully you found this quick guide very helpful and you now have face masks set up within Streamlabs OBS for your stream. And I really would like to see some of your Twitch clips of people donating to you using this function. I'd love to see some examples of this being used in the wild. So do send them to me on Twitter, send them to me on Discord. However you need to get in touch, I would love to see them. I'll probably retweet some of my favorites. As always, I would like to give a massive thanks to my patrons. If you have not yet checked out my Patreon page, these are the people that are helping support Gaming Careers month to month, enabling me to do this full time and keep creating tutorials. Also, I want to say that it is a couple of weeks away from TwitchCon now, which I will be flying over to the United States to go and be a part of TwitchCon. I'm going to be at a lot of the different talks and presentations and things like that, as well as just hanging out. So if you are heading to TwitchCon, also do get in touch. I'd love to meet up with some of you and, you know, have a beer or have a coffee or whatever it ends up being. But thank you very much for watching. Subscribers, I will see you in the next video. Peace.